Welcome back to Written for Life. My name is Chris Page. I'm a pastor in Virginia, and this podcast is to help teenagers know how to study their Bible. And today I've got two guests on the show with me. They are both teenagers, and I wanted to ask them both about their Bible study journey and how they started studying the Bible on their own so that you could hear from some of your peers about how that has worked for them. And so I've got Tom and Ethan here with me today. And so I'm just going to ask them each a couple questions and let them share a little bit about their growth in their Bible study. And again, just a reminder to all the listeners that the goal is not just to help you gain knowledge, but to help you grow in your love for the Lord and in your walk with Jesus so that he's more real in your life and working in your life in a real way. So Ethan, we'll start with you. Talk about when you first started studying the Bible on your own, because that's really what we want to help the listeners is not just go to church and listen to someone preach, but open up the Bible yourself, start reading. Talk about when you started doing that on your own.
So I started really reading the Bible when I was in 10th grade, so I was about 15, 16. So to preface this, I grew up going to church, but I never really like took the time or really cared enough to read the Bible. It was just kind of like I go to church on Sundays, I'll sing worship songs, and then listen to a sermon, and then go home and go about my normal life. It took a couple trips and faltering my steps till I really realized that I need to focus on my relationship with the Lord. So I started off by just reading a chapter every night and trying to pray a little bit more. And as I kind of really like started to love the Lord more and started gaining a relationship with the Lord, I wanted to know more and more about him. And the best way to learn about God is by reading the Bible. So I kind of started out in Matthew, reading and just going over a chapter each night until it evolved into reading a couple sections of the Bible or a couple chapters of the Bible, or just slowing down and trying to dissect a certain part of a chapter of the Bible. So that's kind of where I'd say I started, really, was in 10th grade.
Cool. And I didn't really prepare you for this question, so Tom, you can be thinking about this one. Is when's the first time, you may not be able to remember the exact first time, but one of the first memories of during that, maybe reading Matthew, where you read something and you were like, oh, I get that. And wow, that's cool. Some version of that, you know, of like you really understood what it meant and how that helped you.
So I definitely say, I forgot what chapter in Matthew it was, but I was kind of just like dealing with things. And then I read across the part of Matthew where the disciples are on the boat with Jesus in the middle of the storm and Jesus is sleeping. And the disciples are kind of freaking out. They're obsessing over the storm, even though they had the Savior, the Son of God, in the boat with them. And so they woke Jesus up, and they're like, Jesus, there's a storm. We're all going to die. And Jesus was like, where is your faith? That was the first thing he said to them is, where is your faith? And that kind of made me pause and think, like, so I'm obsessing over the storm right now, but I'm forgetting that the Son of God not only is in a boat, but he's with me every single day. He's with me at all times. So why am I obsessing on the storm and not obsessing on him? So I'd say that's definitely like where I realized, like, whoa, okay.
That's really cool. And what I love about that is because we're trying to help, you know, those of you who are listening to realize that, yes, that all these tools and, you know, classes you can take and commentaries you can read, all that stuff that you can add to help you get better at Bible study, like, he understood that by just reading. You know, he just read the passage, prayed, and asked God to show him something, and it was there. And so just to encourage you, like, that didn't require any theological training to just read that and understand that. And so, Tom, same question for you. When's the first time you really, man, I'm studying the Bible, I'm trying to read it and understand it on my own?
So I had a grew up in a Christian household, and my dad would always have devotion with us every night. And I guess it wasn't until, like, I want to say, like, 7th grade where I started really studying the Bible for myself. And my dad, I remember him always, like, every Bible study, he'd always say, how does this apply to your life? And I think that really kind of stuck with me. When I read my Bible on my own at first, I was just kind of going in with the picture of how does this apply to my own life? I think it wasn't until beginning of freshman year, I really messed up one time. Ethan here knows, but I think I remember coming home that one night and just really, really, it was really burdening me. And so I just decided to open up to, I think it was John. It was John chapter 1. And I think I was just kind of scrolling. I think I was on my phone. And I thought, maybe just open up the app and take a look. Maybe this will help. And I scrolled through John. And it was like, and the red words, it like stood out to me. And it said, it is I, like, do not be afraid or something like that. And it just like, I was like, okay, like God is talking to me here, like he's like right there with me. And I kept reading, and it really stuck with me that God is like, he forgives me, and he's like, he's for me and not against me, I guess. It's just like Jesus forgives every sin you do, no matter how bad it can be. He's always gonna like protect you, and you can always rely on him for help, I guess, when you need it, which was what I was experiencing in that moment, feeling like I was in this kind of pit. But I was.
That's really cool. That's experience. And I think that's another thing that, you know, what you pointed out there is we're trying to help people who are learning to study their Bible to not have the approach of, well, just what does this mean to you? As if it's open to just any interpretation in the world. Right, but there's also this, you know, the author meant to say something, but it's also, there is this subjective sense of that when you're reading the Bible, yes, the author meant this, but the Holy Spirit is using that to minister to you in that moment in a specific way. You know, Jesus is telling the disciples, don't be afraid, it's me. And even though your situation wasn't the same as theirs in that story, Jesus' words to you are still the same, you know? And so that's really cool. All right, second question for both of you guys. We'll go back to Ethan. Is what tools have you used in the last couple of years of studying the Bible that have helped you get better and dig deeper and get more out of it? Whether it's something online or just you started journaling or taking notes, anything like that. What's helped you the most begin to get more out of your Bible study time?
So I always like to use the Bible app. There's a lot of good like plans on there too, with like devotionals. I also started like watching YouTube videos. So my favorite person I like to watch a lot is Mark Winger. He's on YouTube. But he always breaks stuff down to its root level and really kind of shows the hidden meanings within the Bible. And I always found that really fascinating. So that's something that helped me a lot. Another thing is just like talking to fellow Christians and like talking to my student pastor and talking to Chris and to Tom and all my buddies, and really just kind of like trying to understand better, kind of helped me understand things. Like just like highlighting where you have a question or where you don't understand, and then bringing that to someone who can help you answer the question, really, really helped me get better at that. So
that's cool. What about you, Tom? What's helped you get better at it?
I have these two Bible study books, and one's called Morning and Evening by I forgot who the author
is. Spurgeon?
Yes, Charles Spurgeon, that's right. And another one by Timothy Keller. And basically what it does is that you read a verse and they go through the verse and they just almost like dissect it each morning and each evening. And if you really want to, you can go back to that verse and look it up in the Bible and also go through with the Bible study. And I think that's really helpful for me.
Yeah, another website that I like to use a lot too is, it's called gotquestions.org. And you can kind of pretty much type anything in there, specific verses, what the verses mean, or certain like themes in the Bible, and it kind of just breaks it down really in a very like neutral format. Which really like just helped me understand deeper certain parts of the Bible.
That's really good. And Tom, what you said, that's kind of, I think, part of my experience in the past too was, you know, I there was experience in middle and high school reading the Bible on my own and, okay, I'm getting something out of this. But what really, I think, helped take it to the next level was I was given a devotional called The Godward Life by John Piper as a graduation gift. And the same kind of layout, you know, it quotes a Bible verse at the top, and then he spends a few paragraphs explaining it. And that just, it took you to this whole other level of seeing, okay, there's the verse. Oh, and here's what they're saying they got out of it and why they got that out of it. And now it's like, it's almost you like subconsciously learned what they did.
It's like seeing another person's perspective and not your own, and then you can apply that.
Yeah, and then let's you go read a different verse and begin to like, oh, I can do the same thing they did. You know, and start to see things that I missed before.
It's like different interpretations for different people. I guess it kind of brings back to that point of, like, do not be afraid with Ethan and the boat. And for me as well, I guess it's like your different situation. I guess like God's same words can apply to different situations, I guess.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah, it's interesting because it's a hard line, I think, for people to understand, and it's debated among some people, but it's, you know, the Bible, essentially, every passage has one meaning with many applications. But I also think each passage of Scripture has layers of meaning. You know, there's things that on first reading I'm going to understand at an elementary level. And then I'm going to read it again later, and I'm going to get the seventh grade level. And I'm going to read it again as a college student. I'm going to get the master's degree level, you know. So it's like the verse didn't change in meaning. I just understood more of the depths of the meaning.
Like new layers.
Yeah.
Like switching from black and white to color to HD to 4K.
Yeah. And so, you know, I think that's what Tom was getting at with when you read some of these guys, these preachers from the past, or you know, when they unpack a verse for you, it's like, I've read that same verse and I've never gotten out of it before. You know, it's, you're gaining the wisdom of the time they've spent digging into it to get into the deeper stuff that's there. And that can help you, again, learn to do that in other places. So. Well, I appreciate you guys being on and sharing some of this, and I hope it helped you guys that are listening, encourage you that, again, if you're middle school, high school, you can do this. Just start reading your Bible, praying and asking God to teach you. And when you slow down and take your time and really listen for the Holy Spirit to guide you through it, He will show you things and speak to you through His Word, and will help you in your everyday life. But thanks for listening, and we'll see you next time.